internet! I'm HamsterBomb, and you are back for some more Ask Hamster! Anyway, let's just get on with it.
Do you have a phobia besides Pepe's taking over the world?
That doesn't bother me in the slightest. They all know their place, and they're gonna stay there if they know what's good for them.
But aside from a couple obvious things like heights and spiders, I absolutely, for some reason, cannot stand the open ocean, or especially being underwater in the open ocean. If I like can't reach the bottom in the water, then that's wrong to me. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's like, I think it's the same thing of like feeling like you're in space or just like boundless who knows what out there, and you're in the middle of it, and I don't know where, how far away I am to anything, and it's just wrong. I can't stand that feeling.
Is this a question?
Grammatically, yes. Dude, I think I found Supreme Arcanine's long-lost brother named Man JTV, who looks just like him and does pokey videos too, if I even said that name right. And I know Dallas actually has a brother named Dylan. He did some videos with him after he wanted to stop. I think he wanted to stop shiny hunting on his YouTube channel and said he was doing just some fun video stuff with his brother. And I feel kind of bad for his brother, actually, because I mean, he tried that for a while, and he lost a ridiculous amount of subscribers. Well, I mean, to be fair, he was totally changing what his channel was, and people weren't, you know, wanting to stay subscribed to that. I stayed because and I tell you guys this too, when you subscribe to somebody on YouTube, you should subscribe to them. You are there for what they create, and you like them for who they are, not what they have been doing in the past. You know, if somebody, people change, you know? So I feel really bad because after he did that with his brother, he only made like 3 videos with him. He eventually, I think he even took off a lot of videos he was making on his channel announcing that he was changing things. I think he even took some off with his brother and went back to shiny hunting, and now he's popular again. So I don't know how I feel about that. I know that's probably, if not who you're talking about, I know it's just a joke, but either way, just sad story about his brother.
What is the worst game you have ever played?
It's really hard to define worst. I mean, is the worst game the one that I had the biggest expectations to and was really let down, or one that, you know, I just randomly picked up, didn't know anything about, and played my whole way through and I just couldn't stand it? You know, I mean, there's a bunch of junk games out there too you can buy for, you know, like a couple bucks, and I'm sure they're no good. But the worst game I've ever played, you know, the big one that comes to mind, I actually made a video of on my old channel when I was Ocarina Hero 10. It's called Next Life. The game is atrocious. If you really want to see old videos of me, you should check that video out. Okay, so my question is, which Nintendo Switch game that has been announced, except Breath of the Wild, are you most excited for? I like how you had to say except Breath of the Wild, because that's basically the only Switch game that matters right now. Nobody else is really excited about anything else other than Breath of the Wild. Breath of the Wild is selling that console, let's be honest. But I mean, if I was going to buy another game off of that based on what has already been announced, because I know there's a lot more stuff that's staying secret, like I bet you that Monster Hunter Double Cross's English version is going to be released on the Switch. If not Monster Hunter Generations, there's going to be some sort of port there for a new Monster Hunter. There's more than likely going to be some form of a Pokemon game that's already been announced. Whether it's actually going to be a new generation, which I doubt, or is it actually going to be just, you know, some new Pikachu going on an adventure game, which is more than likely what it really is going to be, or a new Rumble or something like that. I probably wouldn't get those unless it was like a main series Pokemon game then, of course. But of what they have told us, oh, and also they've told us there's going to be a No More Heroes 3. I might have to get that. But aside from those, the big one that I might get that is Mario Odyssey. And that's weird because I've played through and loved Xenoblade Chronicles. It's one of my favorite games on the Wii. Problem is, I don't know, the sequel that they're making, just, it just doesn't look like it, the same thing to me. You know, it's like too animated up. I don't know, I really wish they just made an English version of that trailer when they launched it. That might have helped a lot too, but man, I don't know. The art style is just rubbing me the wrong way so badly that, to me, it's rubbing me the wrong way badly. Not I'm saying that it looks bad, like it looks okay, but it just doesn't look Xenoblade to me. And I look at it, I'm like, I'm content with where I played. Mario Odyssey, long roundabout way of answering that question.
Do you still play Pokemon Go?
Funny question. Not really. No, I don't. Actually, this whole year, I don't think I've even opened that game for more than a minute. Like, I open it up occasionally thinking, whoa, is there anything actually right on me right now? No, there's not. And then I'm reminded of why I stopped, because there's nothing but Pidgeys and Rattatas everywhere. Weedles and all sorts of just junk. There's just nothing around. There's lots of executes in my area, but once you make your eighth executor, you're like, mm-hmm. Plus, I really, really get bothered in that game of how you have to actually redeem your points from your gym daily on the dot of exact, like, the right time. Otherwise, you're wasting time. The time doesn't stack. I find that to be so stupid, but, I mean, the whole reason was they want you to have your game on all the time. But, I mean, obviously, I couldn't do that. And, you know, for the few times I wanted to go to gyms, you know, it took way too long to figure that out. I don't know. The game was just too cryptic. I think they're not making updates fast enough. They need a much bigger team to work on that game for it to be as large as it was. I don't think that Niantic had, you know, the group of people, the manpower, to actually work faster on that console or that title. So, unfortunately, I think that's why it dropped so fast. Aside from school, you know, school, of course, is really going to tank stuff. I mean, I feel like their Halloween and, for the most part, their Christmas events were really cool and exciting and got me back into playing it. Since then, nothing has even interested me, even in the least. I mean, like, we were all expecting Johto, and we just got a few baby Pokemon. We're all like, lame. Like, sure, I want to go hatch eggs in Pokemon Go, right? What is your favorite monster in all of Monster Hunter? That's a good question. I don't know, normally I actually say Rajang just because of the terrifying threat that he gives you. Devil Joe is also another really fun one, like a wild card who shows up to just mess you over. But at the moment, who I'm really missing and really wanting to fight in Monster Hunter is Dire Morales, the endgame Elder Dragon of Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. That thing was awesome, and as of yet, that's the only game he's appeared in. Awesome, awesome reason to invest in Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. I didn't really look at Monster Hunter Double Cross that much, and I don't fully understand what it is. Is it a separate game or an expansion? And do I have to buy it from Nintendo's store if it is an expansion? Well, as of right now, it is a Japanese-only game, so don't really worry about it. There will be an announcement for an English version later, and everything I'm about to say might be completely null and it might not matter, but I can at least tell you what it is in Japan. In Japan, it is a separate game, but the thing is, you can also recognize generations, or in their case, Monster Hunter Cross data, and it will transfer up into your new game, so you don't have to replay all the quests again, you don't have to get all your equipment again, things like that. But, you know, your equipment sets, and there's a couple other things, you know, registered sets, things that you have custom saved on your SD card, no, I'm sorry, into the actual game cartridge, that will not stay. So for the most part, it's okay. You know, it's kind of like an expansion, but at the same time, to me, it's like $40 DLC to buy what you already have again. And you know, like, I think we're past this point in video game history where we don't need to be doing this anymore. You know, if you're going to make DLC, and then for the most part, Monster Hunter Generations and for the past games have been great with DLC, but I think they're handling what they think a new game is, and they're kind of stiffing us on it a bit. So yeah, it's technically a separate game, but you can treat it like an expansion. If you could choose any Rotom transformation, what is your favorite? By the way, love your videos. You know, of all the Rotom forms, and some of them are really silly, I never really fought with Rotom at all yet. I really wanted to. The reason is I don't have a shiny yet. But I've got to say, I think my favorite Rotom they've ever made was the most creative one in my opinion, which is this one, the Pokedex Rotom. It's just, I don't know what it is about this, it's just them thinking, you know, just this represents the pure creativity that came out of Pokemon Sun and Moon, which I think is just brilliant. The only thing I really have against this little guy is when I open up my game and I try and do something right away, and he pops up and he says, "Hey, Meester, I think we should get my own Z-Crystal. It would be really powerful. I know what I could do. Oh, what, do you want to hit the fly button? I don't give a crap. Oh, do you want to go in your items? I don't give a crap either. Look at me, I'm talking." And he turns into Navi a little bit. Not quite that obnoxious, but still, I don't know, I kind of overstated myself, didn't I there? Dude, video number 1,000? What? I actually have way more videos than 1,000. I don't know where you got that number from, but at the moment, I think I'm at 1,000. Here, I'm gonna check right now. 1,183, and I'm uploading as we speak, so that's not even correct. So, yeah, there's believe me, there's more than that. And I make, like, at least one video every single day. Weekends get two, and I'm streaming on top of that.
What?
Love your vids. So my question is, have you ever played a Harvest Moon / Story of Seasons? Also, will you ever play a Pokemon ROM hack in the future? No, I haven't gotten a chance to play either of those games. I really, you know, there's a bunch of games that I want to be able to play in the future. I want to try a bunch of different stuff, you know, like I did with Metal Gear. And even though Metal Gear turned into its own huge, you know, franchise thing on my channel, you know, God of War, I wanted to do the same thing. But of course, you know, things happen with Kim and, you know, it's getting harder and harder to schedule time to, with her to actually just record stuff. But yeah, there's a bunch of games I want to be able to try and play like that. But at the moment, you know, it's getting kind of hairy and I got it really picky choosy on which ones I do. As for a Pokemon ROM hack, no, I haven't played any and I don't think I will. You know, I don't want to play that much Pokemon on my channel. Like, I already play a whole lot of it. People call me PokeTuber all the time and that drives me insane. I don't know why. It's a little pet peeve of mine. I do not like being labeled as a PokeTuber. I want to play so many different things on my channel, and Pokemon is very important to me. I do really like Pokemon, but I don't want to be labeled that, because then that means people have, once again, like I was saying about Supreme Arcanine, they have a labeled expectation of what they want out of my channel, and if all of a sudden, 1 month later, I'm not having any Pokemon videos, I'm just playing, you know, Uncharted, Bioshock, you know, a bunch of different stuff, and came out of nowhere, you know, and all of a sudden, all the Pokemon subscribers, they leave. And I'm like, well, see, that was their missed interpretation of what the channel was. I don't want people to think that. And what people on Steam, or no, I'm sorry, as streaming was thinking that I should be called instead, is they prefer the term OmniTuber. Why is it when you transport something by car, it's called a shipment? And when you transfer something by ship, it's called cargo.
Why do we cook bacon and bake cookies?
Do you plan to do more Pokemon randomizers in the future, aside from Colosseum, if you can get that working? I don't have any others planned after that right now. I don't plan two of them ahead. I only think of my next one as I'm playing one of them so far. That's how it's been. And at the moment, I don't have any plan. And I can confirm for you, I literally just yesterday got that working. But there's an interesting problem we're gonna run into right away in that series. It might not even be possible to play. Long story, you'll see in episode one. What do you think you'll do when your channel hits 100,000 subs? Or have you thought of what you would do? No, I didn't really think of it because, I mean, right now, I just kind of fly on the seat of my pants right now. So, I mean, I don't know. Any recommendations? Tell me what you want me to do. So, I have been terrible at Monster Hunter all the way since Tri. The fact that I can actually play Generations and have a good time fighting cool monsters is really nice for me. Since you are good at the game, could you let me know what is wrong with Generations and what could fix it? That is a fantastic question. That's what I want people to say here because there's a lot of little problems that all add up to a really big problem with Generations that the other Monster Hunter games just don't have in general. Now, there's so many things that I'm actually thinking about making my own video on it, discussing the whole thing. Probably gonna get a lot of hate for it, but I mean, whatever, that's what happened when I made the video about Monster Hunter Cross when that thing was announced. Same thing. But really briefly, and we try and go really quick with this, hunters have been completely overpowered due to hunting styles and hunter arts. Monsters have all been nerfed due to the sheer number of how many are in the game. Their HPs have been lowered, and there's too many of them, and their rare items have been easier to come by. The upgrading system, though inventive, completely devalues all rare items and usually doesn't even need them. Fighting in groups, which is the main point of Monster Hunter, really, is really just overpowering anything you go and try and fight. The only time the game really gets difficult is in late higher rank when they're basically overcompensating the fact that they accidentally made low rank a joke. I could go on, but I'll leave it at that. Hi Hamster, I'm relatively new to your channel and have enjoyed all of your videos that I have watched thus far, but my question is, will you be my friend? Why is that always everyone's first inclination to ask me that? And for the real question, when is the next time you will play more God of War / any game really with Kim? And if you do, you should alternate who plays throughout the series. You see, Kim and I this year are working on planning on the wedding. We're also working at the house. We have a lot of stuff that we're trying to do when we actually are together at the same time. And it can't really be play video games, unfortunately. I wish we could. We got to do that, obviously, more in the past, but God of War, fortunately, we got to finish God of War, but we couldn't keep playing more of it right away. We do want to keep going back and play more of it, but as of now, that's going to be a while because we've got You know, especially in this year, we got a lot going on. So, aside from God of War, though, I am going to try my best to get Kim to join me on a new series using the Nintendo Switch that actually just got donated to us. Thanks again, John Walter. Seriously, donated Switch, guys. That's huge. We might be able to make our own new Let's Play together, Kim and I. Depends on how you record on that system or not. So far, we have no idea how to even do it, if it's even possible, because it's all cartridge-based. I would like to do maybe a streamed version of Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I would love to do that. And it would actually be Kim's first Zelda game. That'd be amazing. Hamster, I have two questions to consider for the next one. What is the proper way to greet an explosive hamster?
I prefer His Highness or Your Majesty. Occasionally, if I'm on my good side, I'll also accept His Excellency.
Would you consider doing a Let's Glitch series for one of the games you play, either showing off random glitches you like, or playing through while triggering as many glitches as you possibly can? I'm not talking about using a cheating device slash randomizer, I'm talking about actual glitches within the game itself. You see, not really, because I actually worked on programming video games for a while, several years, and I even taught one of my classes in video game production, and there's something about glitching stuff that's funny for a second, but, I mean, because I know that was something that the programmers either missed or they were trying to fix and something weird happened, or something that was overlooked in the game, real people worked on these things, and it just, it to me, it also kind of like, I feel bad for them, you know, So it wouldn't all be the same for me doing it, so it's probably best that I not do that.
You see a taco shell and a sausage next to each other. Which one do you lick?
I'm on to your dirty tricks, you dirty, dirty people.
Here's a question for you. Will you do fan meetups? I happen to live close by you and would love to meet you.
How do you know where I live?
Well, here's a way to test the water then. Everybody who's near Cincinnati, Ohio, within reasonable driving distance, let me know if you'd be willing to meet up with me if we went somewhere, I don't know, somewhere in the area you guys can recommend, and we'll just go do something. I don't know. Just test it. How many people would be able to do that? Because that's not up to me, that's up to you guys. Otherwise, it's just me meeting one person, which, no, I'm sorry, I don't have time to do that. I'd love to, I would. But I don't have time to do that. If there was a lot more people, yeah, I'd like make videos out of it. That'd be a lot of fun. But for sure, you know, if it ended up just being one person, I'd be like, I'm sorry, I hope you don't feel awkward, but I really have a lot of other stuff that I should be doing right now.
After playing through the Metal Gear series, do you think of Snake being in Brawl any differently now?
Funny question, because I actually played mainly as Snake in Brawl. And, not really. If anything, I have a new appreciation for his, codec calls on his own stage you can make, because they got the original voice actors from the first game, which is kind of awesome.
Alex, I have an answer and a question. First of all, I'm your favorite viewer.
Is that so? I'm gonna put that to the test today. I've got an idea. I'm gonna make another video. I'm gonna film it. I'm gonna show you guys who really is my favorite viewer. No, not my favorite viewer. Who's my number one fan? YouTube has this algorithm that actually sorts people based on how much they watch, how engaged they are, how many likes they leave, and it sorts them and ranks them all out for me to see. We'll see, Shark Attack. We'll see about that. Also, what's your favorite shiny in Pokemon Sun and Moon? At the moment, because I can't seem to find it, is Marini. You know, I want, as much as I want a shiny, that's how much it's value to me. It's not so much like the pattern, sometimes. I mean, you know, it's like, Seviper looks really cool. You know, sure, I really like some shinies like that. But at the same time, the more I want it, and you know, I could hatch and get it real simply. So, sort of, supposedly. I can't hatch worth crap. For some reason, my luck is atrocious with hatching. I've never hatched faster than 1,275 eggs or so. That was my fastest hatch ever, and I've hatched 5 shinies. So, no. But aside from that, I mean, I think Marini has to be number one, just because it's so hard to try and get this thing. I have it on right now here, actually. I'm planning on maybe streaming if I have some time today, going for some more shiny Corsola. I don't know. Hopefully Moltres shines as well, too. That's another one I'm hunting right now. Ask Hamster13. Can't wait for bad luck to strike. Bad luck? That sounds almost like my temporarily death turning into permanentarily death. Uh-oh. Who can say what your heart says? Great. I honestly want you to play Kid Icarus Uprising. Even after 4 years, it's still just above Monster Hunter and my all-time favorite game. And then you kind of go on for a very long time saying about why it's such a great game. I'm gonna tell you why I don't think so. I really don't like that game. I'm sorry, I just really don't like that game. Now, to be fair, I never played it through. I only played it for like 5 minutes, and I got like a severe headache trying to play it. I don't know what it was about that game, how it's like so flashy and over the top, so much is going on at once. And I think the biggest thing that honestly really bothered me was that I played the first Kid Icarus game. It is hard, but at the same time, I got a really good appreciation for what it was trying to do and what it was. And literally the dead opposite of that game is Uprising. So I look at him like, that is being so unfaithful to what you made before. There's so much they could have done to bring back that original game and fix it in a way that makes Uprising, the new pit game they wanted to make, a lot more relatable to where he started and, you know, pushing forward into maybe ending where it's like that over the top and ridiculous, because Pit really becomes pretty darn OP in the end of Kid Icarus. So, I don't know, but that's just my opinion. Really, a lot of it was the non-stop crazy gameplay. It just seriously gave me a headache. I couldn't play it. Hate to sound like such a downer, but do you live in the same city where Harambe was shot? Yes, and it really bothers me how that, like, exploded over the internet. People are, like, so rude and insensitive. I don't know, because every year of my life, I'm pretty sure, I at least got to go to the zoo and saw that gorilla. I remember some funny stories with that gorilla, too. I remember when we were in, like, first grade, there was this class jerk, hated this guy. And he was, of course, causing trouble with everybody, but they were by the gorillas, and what he did was he actually started picking up rocks and throwing them at the gorilla. So, like, total jerk, but serves him right. Harambe starts picking up his own crap, big mounds of it, and chucking them back at him. I don't think he actually got hit, I don't know if anybody did, because he was just kind of, like, whipping, you know, tons of poop back at everybody. But still, yeah, I mean, I actually saw him, I think it was 2 days before he got shot. It was just happened to be right before everything happened. I went there with Kim and a few of her friends from work. I don't think I got to bring one of my friends at all. No, I don't think I did. But anyway, we were just there, which was why I was really sad too. Because Kim is one of those who likes to learn all the animals' names. And so we were spending some time, you know, memorizing, you know, all the names of all the gorillas there. So I actually, when they said his name at first on the news, I knew which one they were talking about, which was horrible because it was their huge male. But yeah, long story short, yeah. Also, if Monster Hunter had a real deep plot, what would you want it to be? I think Monster Hunter's plot, if anything, needs to be, if it's going to have a really deep plot, it needs to be like a revenge kind of story, where, similar to the whole concept of why people like Freedom Unite so much, you've got like this revenge thing against the Tigrex, because in the very beginning, it just knocks you off this cliff, it destroys you, and you've always got this idea, as you're working your way up as a hunter, I'm gonna take that thing down, I wanna take that thing down, but at the same time, I'm really scared of it, right? So that is a game where the story was developed in the head of the player, something that never ever happens in, you know, generations, but they did a great job, I think, at 4 Ultimate of, you know, working around their own story into it. They did a pretty good job of doing the same thing in Try as well. But anyway, yeah, if they were gonna do something like that, I think like more of like a revenge story and actually using some characters. Maybe a very close character to you gets killed by a monster or gets, you know, you get separated from them because of an attack on one on your caravan or something like that. I don't know, I think there's a lot they could do there. How would you react if I traveled to Cincinnati, Ohio, vigorously looked through the windows of every house until I was lucky enough to see you through one of them, left a note saying Atomic Thomas was here, first of all, how would you react to the note, and then proceed to knock on your door? What would you say to me and what would happen after that? Video collab maybe? I need to know! Actually, I would call the police. I really recommend you see what Dauntless is. It is a pre-alpha and it already looks amazing. This is coming from a Monster Hunter veteran. Yeah, I've seen Dauntless and... See, to me, it's like, even, I don't care, even if it does Monster Hunter better and it fixes a lot of things, it is directly stealing, though. I mean, it's like, I don't know. It's like if you made an obvious Mario game and instead of playing as Mario, you played as, like, an electrician, you know, and he's got a big E on his hat. You know, it is so obviously stolen that I can't get into it. I mean, even if it's better, that's the thing. Even if it's amazing, I bet it probably will be. It's a free-to-play game, though. That's why I'm like, I don't know. It's probably going to be one of those pay-to-win games. But something about it just really bothers me, rubs me the wrong way. I had to ask a few other people about the same thing, too. Non-Monster Hunter fans are not interested in it, like, at all, which is already something that concerns me. It's basically stealing Capcom's audience, and that is a bad thing, because sure, I understand, as a person who just wants to play the video games, it probably looks great now you got another Monster Hunter game to play, right? But I'm also thinking in terms of Capcom, the company, making new Monster Hunter games and trying to develop new content for their audience. Now, a lot of their audience is one either being stolen or now has changed expectations of what this company needs to do. And I'm sure, yeah, friendly competition is fine, but at the same time, that, in my opinion, isn't competition, that's stealing. If you're, like I said, I was working on independent video games as well. I think the best video games you can come up with are ones where you're just using your own creativity to make your own video game. Dauntless, in my opinion, is a total ripoff, and though it looks fun, I don't think I can play it. Do you sometimes watch your own episodes? For example, when you want to see how you were playing in the past. Actually, yeah, there's sometimes where I have to watch my own episodes. There's usually what happens is I'm editing, obviously. But other times when I need to watch my own episodes, I'm like uploading a lot of videos online and I can't use the internet like at all. So I'm literally just sitting here, maybe shiny hunting and recording, and I'm just like, well, can't seem to do anything else right now. How did that fight in the Elite Four go? You know, I open up that old video cue charm and I just watch something. Or I'm like, how did I deal with this in Peace Walker? I open up that video, you know, and I just, you know, just kind of watch something. But other than that, like, usually it's not really to go back and see how I played things in the past, though. Sometimes I would go back and, like, more listen if I'm working on something else. Listen to an old playthrough I did. Oh my gosh, of, like, super old videos I've got, you know, just to think of, notice what I've done that has changed over time, and what could I keep doing that would keep changing what I'm doing now to get myself to, you know, improve even more, if I improved at all. Hamster, will you shiny hunt legendaries in Heart Gold Q Charm? Don't forget to brush your teeth with potatoes. I never forget to brush my teeth with potatoes, but actually, yeah, right now, like, sitting here at the moment, is actually Pokemon Heart Gold, like, literally as we speak. I'm gonna do this after I'm done. Standing in front of Moltres. Right now, Moltres has 2,050, I believe, soft resets on it. 1,600 of those were actually done in my sister's Soul Silver game that I played up through the story in order to get into it so I could do two resets at once on it. The only reason I switched over to Heart Gold instead is because I have a lot more of Kurt's balls in that game, and I really want to get it in a Kurt ball, especially, like, you know, a pink one, like a love ball or a heal ball, maybe. It's not Kurt's ball, but it's another pink one. But I got a ton of Kurt's balls, and I'm going to try and catch it in if I'm lucky. But yeah, it's not having anything to do with Q Charm, though. This just happens to be my Q Charm game. Magic will not help those at all. They are genderless, and it will do absolutely nothing to the encounter. If anything, it might even screw it up. Can you tell me your address so I can murder you for not liking Final Fantasy? Just kidding. Just like a Final Fantasy fan to, one, not know when to give up, but two, jump to ridiculous conclusions. And no, that's not even funny. But two questions. Other than Breath of the Wild, is there any games you're looking forward to? Well, you said games in general, so actually, that's a good point. I want to talk about Hideo Kojima's new game that he's working on, Death Stranding. It just looks so fascinating because it's so unconventional. It's like everything I can see that he wanted to do with Konami, and this is what they were saying no to. It's what I'm seeing, you know? And why they were like, no, we can't do that, we can't do that. I really want to see that game succeed, you know, just to stick it back to Konami for being so rude to him. Seriously, so rude to him. If you don't know anything about the drama of anything going on between Kojima and Konami, it's fascinating. Seriously, it's just weird. Can you get me McDolans and syrup? I don't even know what you're talking about. haven't been able to catch up on my H-bomb vids. What is your favorite Alola form, and which one would you add into the game? You know, I haven't gotten a chance to raise all of them yet, and design-wise, I really like the Alolan Vulpix and Ninetales, but of the ones that I've gotten to play with, I really like the Alolan Muk, and especially the Alolan Raichu. It's really great. I'm super disappointed in their shinies, though. There's like none of the Alolan shinies I look at, and I'm like, yes, I really want to get that. They're all more like, I like your normal form though. Who would I add into the game? I actually think that poor Dragonite's line has been screwed out of the last few generations of not getting anything special added to him. You know, he missed out on Mega Evolutions, and I feel like now he's missing out on Alola forms, and it was all Kanto stuff. You know, and obviously they said they wanted to do callbacks to people who, you know, really enjoyed Pokemon from the first generation on. So, my generation, yay, but the thing is, people from my generation aren't going to tell you, oh yeah, my favorite Pokemon from the first generation was Rattata, it was Meowth, you know, it was Diglett. They picked, let's be honest, some really weird Pokemon to give the Alolan forms to. I feel like, sure, some of them were creative and really neat, but at the same time, there were some really, really popular Pokemon who never got anything else extra added to them. Fortunately, Raichu got it, not Pikachu. That makes me so happy. But there's some really big ones, like I said, Dragonite, who missed out on Mega Evolutions, and so far is really not being used competitively, and I think really needs, you know, something really cool to change how he works. So I was thinking maybe like, I don't know, like a water fire, you know, like a water fire dragon-ish kind of thing. I don't know, just, I really want to mix water fire. Like, I know right now only Volcanion has that, but I mean, Dragonite and their whole line really swims in the water all the time, and imagine it was like, you know, these dragons that inhibit around volcanoes. I just think it'd be so cool. So I noticed after that huge subscriber explosion in summer, it's been slowing back down again recently. Do you know what happened? Like Lotus says, people go to work, school, etc. You know, Lotus, it's actually not just that. I mean, sure, that adds into it, but that's only like a small fraction of how that actually changes. To be fair, and this is across YouTube altogether, January and February, for some reason, I don't really know why, maybe it's the back to school, you know, idea that people just really, you know, I don't know, either just work on something, either school or their work, but YouTube dies in January and February. It drops like a rock. It literally plummets. And in the fall is when it's really hitting really hard. So to be fair, you were comparing it already when YouTube itself is very popular versus now when it's usually not watched as much. Aside from that, YouTube recently changed a very important algorithm, which, if you haven't heard about it, has really screwed over a lot of YouTubers out there, to where basically a lot of weird stuff has been happening, but basically the biggest problem is if you're subscribed to somebody, you're still not getting your information about what videos they're currently making, and it doesn't show up in your feed. Instead, YouTube shows you videos that they want you to watch and not what you want to watch. That is a huge problem. YouTube may be getting more click views out of that in the end. I don't know. They're making more money, but the thing is, they're basically robbing everybody else who was going to be getting those views to begin with. So that is knocking everybody down like 90% as is. And then add on top of that the fact that it's just January. This just happens. So it's dropped down again. So, I mean, whatever. To be fair, if anything, live streaming just on YouTube, that's a super recent thing I started doing. Live streaming on YouTube, I'm finding, as opposed to Twitch, is really being beneficial to the channel as opposed to just doing it on Twitch. So I think that's gonna be a good thing, and it's gonna help us, you know, push the channel forward in the future.
Fan meet and greet!
Do you have time? No. I wouldn't make time though, I would make time. Speaking of shirts, interested in designing and selling? I bet a lot of us would like a HamsterBomb shirt. You know, there's actually been several people talking to me about that, and the problem with that idea is, well, one, I can tell you, I already have HamsterBomb shirts. I do. They're not of my YouTube channel, though. They're of my comic stuff, but it's still a HamsterBomb shirt. Now, the reason that I say you gotta calm down about that, because a lot of people tell me about this, is because they make absolutely no money. Like, you lose money making these. It costs, I'm not kidding, thousands of dollars to get the supply, and then you've gotta be able to ship everything out, and then sell them in a way that you would think makes a profit. But the thing is, the only way to actually make a profit on them is to sell, like, I don't know, at least 60% of the supply that came in to start making any profit off of what you paid to get the supply. And then on top of that, you know, you're expecting someone to pay so much on top of how much it costs you to even get them individually, which would really be like $25 to $30 per shirt, and they're white t-shirts with a print on them, you know, versus, you know, a bunch of other things that I've got as well. But still, it's super expensive. I don't think it's really worth it, though. If anything, maybe over time on Patreon, if we could work up, you know, high enough funds on there to where people who are, you know, paying, you know, like $5 a month or something, for example, would eventually just start getting gifts sent to them all the time. That'd be great. I would love to do that. But the thing is, like I said, we have to work up the funds to do that first. That's very expensive to start. Hamster, what do you think the next Pokemon game will be? If there will be one, because I heard some rumors. Also, will you play it? Well, for one, of course there's going to be another Pokemon game. It's not like this franchise is just done. This whole generation was such a failure. We're done forever. I'm assuming you're talking about the Switch. And, yeah, it depends on what is going to be released on Switch. Like I said before, if it's just another one of those Pikachu adventure games, no, I'm not going to play that. If it's a main series title, yeah, I'm gonna play it. And if there is something else that they're doing, you know, maybe like some new Rumble game or something like that, I might try it. I've never played any Rumble. I played like a free version on my DS or something like that for a while. But no, I've never played any of the, you know, other side Pokemon games. I don't want to play too much Pokemon, like I've also been saying before, even though I loaded this all up with Pokemon. Also, will I play it? Well, yeah, that's kind of answering that same thing. Like, it depends. It really depends on largely what it is and how they go about, you know, working in new ideas into the same game. I don't want them to keep rehashing stuff, which is why I think Sun and Moon was such a big success for Pokemon. And that is all we have for this time. So if you want to have me read your comment in the next Ask Hamster, leave it down in the comment section below. But either way, thank you all so much for watching. Remember to like the videos and subscribe for more. And I will see you all in the next Ask Hamster. Booyah.
Wait, look at me instead! Hey, tap over here! Look, I don't care if you want to use your items or talk to your Pokemon. I don't care. Hey, look at me. Hey, I got a great idea for a new Z-move. Hey, did you tell Lilia that I was going over here? Hey, how's my best friend? How's my best friend? Hey, you want to give a friend a how? Hey, slow wave for how? Oh, I love you, friends. Hey, look. Oh, wait. Oh, should I let you use your items?
I'll see you guys next time.